try. When we go out to the lost with the attitude of Jesus, God is going to use us to influence the non-believers. Are you ready?
This is the power of youth, that God can do it for you.
You are a ruler over all the situations that you face in your campuses, in your homes, because in God's plans, you are a ruler.
If you have never felt smart enough, or talented enough, or good enough, or brave enough, let me encourage you tonight. You are the perfect candidate that God is looking for. God seldom calls the qualified. He qualifies the call. Come on, give God a big hand. Hallelujah.
Oh God, tonight, Lord, we will be like the woman with the issue of blood. We will cry out for our breakthrough. We will hunger for more of you. Oh God, tonight, unless we touch your presence, God, we will not be satisfied.
The voice of God. Some of you are going to be sent into your generation in very powerful places. You're going to walk the corridors of power, and you're going to touch many, many realms of people that you never imagined. But through you, revival will come to your generation. God is going to use you to build His church. God is going to use you to lead thousands upon thousands to Christ. Oh, just believe, 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 believe. Nothing is impossible with God. Only believe.
All right, Emerge, make some noise! Wait. This, the theme of this year's Emerge...
Tiredness. It's a long day. A bit tired.
No. The theme of this year's Emerge is...
Silence! The last row. Oh, never scream. I can see from here.
Come on, let's show Chloe what Emerge power is. Emerge, make some noise! All right,
Brandon, so were you here at yesterday's Emerge?
Of course.
Do you see the performances?
Of course.
And which was your favorite one?
All of them.
That's not what he said just now.
Let's take this off stage.
Okay, but guys, if y'all didn't see the performance yesterday, it's fine because today you're in luck. We'll be bringing back the two winners of Emerge Got Talent.
Yeah, that's right. So these two performances have been through rigorous judging. They were cut down from 30 to 10 to 4 last night. And last night we chose the two winners of Emerge Got Talent.
That's right. And first up, we'll be bringing the first runner-up. This team is called D-Compact, and they're from LYL and ZY Zone. So something about this team, they've introduced themselves as four compact girls with a lot of fans that won't stop screaming, but it's very good because they said they are very energetic. Yeah. So let's bring to stage D-Compact.
Listen up, we're looking for a cruise. If you're with me, let me see your hands. Get up and salute. Get your killer heels, sneakers, pumps, I'll lace up your boots. Representing all the women, salute. So ladies all across the world, listen up, we're looking for recruits. If you're with me, let me see your hands. Get up and salute. Get your killer heels, sneakers, pumps, I'll lace up your boots. Representing all the women. Boy, I think you know who run this town. I ain't pushing for no bet, 'cause I already know what you're trying to say. If you're with me, women, let me hear you say. Ladies all across the world, listen up, we're looking for recruits. If you're with me, let me see your hands up. Get your killer heels, sneakers, pumps, all lace up your boots. Representing all the women,
was amazing. Everybody, let's give D-Compact another big hand. Wow, that was amazing. You know what? I'm very inspired also.
Not too bad, Brandon. I heard some cheers over there.
Yeah, thank you. I think we can join D-Compact.
Just now, we are a bit confused.
Let's deconflict off stage.
All right. I think y'all don't want to see us because we have one more performance coming right up. And this is the winning team of Emerge Got Talent. They are Naomi and Sean from PLBK Zone.
PLBK Zone. Make some noise. All right. Got a lot of fans out there. So these two girls, what can I say about them? They're 22 years old.
22.
Beautiful.
Very beautiful.
Soothing.
Super soothing.
Wonderful.
Very wonderful.
So piercing.
Piercing.
What? I'm talking about their voice, you know, right?
Their voices. So with their piercing, soothing, amazing, wonderful voices, they'll be bringing us the song,
When You Believe.
So let's welcome Naomi and Sean.
With no proof anyone could hear, in our hearts a hope for. what miracles you can achieve when you believe. Somehow you will. You will when you when prayer so often proves in vain, hope seems like the summer birds swiftly flown away. Yet now I'm standing here, my heart so full I can't explain, seeking faith and speaking words I never thought I'd say.
Can somebody shout power?
Power!
One more time, power!
Power!
Let's give Jesus one more big hand.
Well, hi everyone, and welcome to our Emerge Brainiers Youth Finals. Ben, why not you tell us a little bit about this competition?
All right, here in City Harvest, we believe that everybody is called to be salt and light in the world. And we want all of our students to go and shine for Jesus in their campuses, wherever they may be.
Whoa, music. Thank you. Okay, church, tonight we have our top two teams joining us on the big stage. First up, we have our secondary school team. Come on up, secondary school team.
All right, church, let's give them a big hand.
Three very handsome and very, very intelligent guys. We have Samuel, Teddy, and Fanta.
All right. And of course, from the tertiary team, who are equally handsome and equally intelligent, let's welcome Michael, Peter, and Yu-Zhen.
That's right, church. Let's give them another round of applause.
All right, let's tell the church what prizes they will win.
The first one up was Stand to Win $300 worth of capital. CapitaLand vouchers.
All right, and the winning team will stand to win a grand prize of $450 worth of CapitaLand vouchers.
Okay, can you wait? But before we start the game, let us explain to you how it's going to be played.
That's right, there will be a game board with 6 different categories, as you will see on the screen. And each team will get to play the board 3 times, and each time choosing the category that they want to play.
Each category has 10 questions. The team would have to answer the current question before moving on to the next. No passing of questions are allowed. So, you know, the contestants can answer the questions even before the MCs, which is us, have finished reading it.
And each answer will earn them 100 points. Each category will earn them a total of 1,000 points. That's and the time limit for each category is 90 seconds.
That's right. The mathematics category will, however, be an exception because much calculation is involved. So this category will only have 5 questions with an extended time of 120 seconds. This is like an average of 24 seconds per question.
24 seconds.
And contestants would have to answer it with or without a calculator.
With or without. So intense. So intense.
So intense.
Oh my goodness.
But guys, what is a game without a twist, right?
That's right.
The twist of this game is that every team will be given a trump card option. That's right, a trump card option.
All right, and the trump card can be used throughout the game at any time that they want. And the usage of the trump card will help the team to double their points for every correct answer that they answer correctly. So for example, if they answer 5 questions correctly, they will earn 1,000 points instead of 500 points.
Failure to answer the questions correctly will not result in any loss of points.
Alright, so that's good to know. No loss of points.
That's right.
That's
so, the team with the highest accumulated points at the end of 3 rounds will emerge first.
So how many of you think the tertiary people will win today?
How many of you think the secondary school team will win today? Oh yeah.
Alright, let's get to it.
Well Ben, let's stop talking and let's start playing.
Yeah.
Secondary school team, will you come to the center please? That's right, Church, let's give them another round of applause.
Secondary school team.
Encourage them.
Alright, secondary school team, are you guys ready?
Yes.
Alright, so you gotta select the category of your choice.
Math.
Math.
Math it is.
Wow.
And secondary school, do you wanna use your trump card?
No.
No, they do not want to use their trump card. All right, and your time starts now.
The points A and B are coordinates 3, 2, 3, and minus 4 and 1 respectively. Determine the magnitude of vector AB.
All right.
2.
2, is that your final answer?
Yes.
2?
Yes.
Yes.
That is correct. When it is 1200 hours in London, the time in Singapore is 2000 hours. A plane leaves Singapore at 1230 to fly to London. The flight takes 13 hours and 45 minutes. Calculate the time in London when it arrives.
Calculate when you will reach London. Taking
3.
Answer 3, is that your final answer?
Yes.
All right, lock it in. It's correct.
Solve the inequality.
Woo!
X over 4 minus 3x minus 1 over 2 greater than 5.
What is this inequality?
Say what?
What kind of inequality is this?
Oh my goodness.
Solve the inequality.
1.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
Lock it in.
It's okay. 4. The ordered stem and leaf chart shows the distribution of heights in cm of 30 people. So look to the screen for the chart. State a possible value of x if the mode of distribution is greater than 180. Wow, Ben.
Oh my goodness.
I can't even answer this.
I don't remember taking this in secondary school.
Yeah, hard at work, calculating. And then,
4.
4, is that your final answer?
Yeah.
Lock it in. Oh, it's okay. Next question.
Question 5. Mrs. Tay has enough money to buy either 80 pens or 20 wallets. How many pens and wallets can she get that they are of equal quantity?
3.
2.
1.
And your time is up. Well done, guys. You get a total score of 400 points.
Thank you, secondary school. Let's give them a round of applause to encourage them. Oh my goodness, mathematics.
Mathematics, never my strong point.
No, my goodness. All right, it's the tertiary people are up.
Come on, tertiary people, to the center. Tertiary people, which category would you like?
We'll take science.
Science! Would you like to use your trump card?
No.
No, okay. If you're ready, your time starts now.
All right, what is a cavication? What on
three.
Earth? Three.
Three, is yeah. that a final answer? That's right.
What is the longest time it can take for a three. Person to be able to crack the knuckles again?
That's right.
Which brain area affects how we judge risk, control
two.
Our emotions?
Two. That's right, whoa.
And which of the following is not what a person with amusia can do? Amusia. I have no idea what
three.
A person with amusia
that
is.
One. Sorry, one. Sorry, sorry. Four, no, four, is that your final answer, four?
One.
No, four, wait,
four,
one.
Four, one. Hello,
you're having
hello.
A little bit of confusion.
Four, four.
Is that your final answer, four?
Yes, yes.
Oh.
It's wrong, it's all right. Which of the following is true? Oh my goodness. Having friends who are suffering from depression increase the chances of getting depressed. One. Being around friends who are depressed increase
three.
The chances. Three.
Say your final answer. All right.
Question six. What did the scientists not find in tweens and teenagers who have many friends
three.
On Facebook?
Wow.
And the correct answer. All right, question seven. What is the function of a vortex fluidic device? Of a vortex fluidic device.
What is that?
What is the function of a vortex
three.
Fluidic device?
Three, is that your final answer?
Three, yeah.
And which of the
seconds.
Following can you do to boost your memory? Boost your memory.
One.
And your time Woo. Is up!
600
Tertiary,
points!
You scored a total of 600 points!
Oh my goodness.
But fret not, this is only the end of round one.
Round one.
We still have round two, right?
How many rounds are we playing in
we
total?
We are going to play three rounds today.
Three rounds. Well, after the math, I feel like I'm a Brainiers Youth already.
I feel I need to join Brainiers Youth next
oh
year.
Goodness,
so.
Yes, let's do
well,
it.
Well, let's go straight to round two. Secondary school, come to the center, please.
All right, secondary school, please select the category that you want to play.
Geography.
Geography.
Whoa.
Oh, my goodness. Geography. And do you want to use your trump card?
No.
No, no trump card. They're leaving it for the last round, I think. Last round. All right. And your time for geography starts now.
Question one. An ocean gyre is a system
one.
Of circuit... One.
Is that your final answer? One.
Yes.
One. Okay, lock it in. Yes. Lock it in.
Yes, yes, yes.
Number one. Okay. What is the biggest barrier to cleaning up the Great Pacific
one.
Garbage
one.
Patch?
One.
One.
Is that your final
is
answer?
Is that the final answer? Okay, lock
yes.
it in. One.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. I think we need to restart because the question started from question 9 just now.
Yeah, we want to start from question 1.
Alright,
so once again,
VCOM,
we
can
a...
we re-roll geography?
Could we do that?
Can we re-roll geography? Can we hit refresh on this application? Or backspace? Or can we do something?
Can we do something?
Okay, they say they're waving their hands and saying yes or wait.
Wait. Okay, we
all right, just turn
wait.
To your neighbors and say, are you ready to emerge? And while we are still waiting, can somebody say power?
Power.
One more time, power.
Power.
Come on,
praise
guys.
The Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh. The question is, okay, let's restart. Okay, let's do it.
Back to
question
the...
one. Is this geography?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Can we start from the beginning?
Can we start from the beginning?
Yeah, because the time is not right anymore.
Start from the beginning.
Okay, let's get the categories brought up first.
All right, let's get the categories brought up. Let's have the categories up on the screen. All right.
All right, so geography.
Yes. Geography. All right, and your time starts now.
Question one. Which of the following reasons explain why plastics make up the majority of marine debris?
One and four.
One
two,
and four.
Two, two, two.
Two. Is that your final answer? Two.
Yes.
Lock it in. Correct.
The area surrounding the center of a gyre tends
true.
To be very...
True. Yes. True. Lock it in.
Yes.
Final answer.
Oh. Oh. Question three. What is GNI calculator? Wow.
GNI.
I have no idea.
Gross national something. I don't know.
One.
One?
One.
Is that your final answer?
Yes. One. Final answer. Lock it in.
Well done. Wow. Number four. The Great Pacific Garbage Patch is a collection of marine debris in the...
Three. Lock it in. Wow.
Which of the following is the best way to clean up the Great Pacific Garbage Patch? Guys, cannot shout answer.
Yeah, there's no call a friend here or...
Yeah. No 50-50 also.
Two.
Two. Final answer.
Yes.
Okay.
Wind, sunlight, rain, tides, and geothermal energy.
Yeah, true.
True, yes, lock it in, true.
Based on the readings, what accelerated globalization in the 19th century?
Three, lock it in, final answer. Wow.
Question 8, what of the following is an example?
Four, algae, lock it in. Yes.
An ocean gyre is a system of circular ocean currents.
One. Final answer,
what
lock
is the
in.
Biggest barrier?
Oh! Secondary school people are bringing it.
That got me on my toes, man.
Kanchiong.
Kanchiong, really kanchiong.
We're going to invite the tertiary people up to the center of the stage.
Okay, tertiary people. What?
History.
History, wow. Do you want to use the trump card?
Yes.
Yo, trump card. Alrighty.
Well, alright, they want to use their trump card, so they will double the points for every correct answer.
Wow.
Let's do it.
If you guys are ready, your time starts now. Sorry, we're going to pause a little
because we're on question 10. This is question 10. Oh, okay. Let's pull up the category board again.
Trump card, right? Very important.
Trump card. Oh.
Cannot get it wrong, right?
Yeah. All right. History?
History?
With trump card.
History category, please.
And
your time starts now. The State of Singapore Act 1958 saw Singapore converted from a colony into a...
One. May 1959. Final answer.
Yes.
Lock it in.
Question 2. The first master plan of 1958 was the first one since Raffles Town Plan in 1922. What was its goal?
One. Final answer. Oh.
Question 3. The Speak Mandarin campaign was launched in 1979. Which of the following is not one of the aims at launch?
One.
Question 4. The residence committees were formed in 1978. Previously under the Prime Minister's office and later the Ministry of Community Development, what is the RCs operating under today?
Three.
Final answer. Yeah.
Number 5. The British stationing of troops was sealed under the Five Power Defence Agreements, and this agreement still stood years after the British...
One. Final answer.
Question 6. Initially...
Four.
Final answer.
Yes.
Question 7. Singapore's justification for joining the IMF was presented as a bill to the...
One.
Final answer. One.
Question 8. Which year did the chewing gum ban in Singapore?
One.
1982.
Question 9. Which union was seen as the main antagonist for the spread of communism?
Thank you, tertiary. 600 points.
600 and, points.
But ladies and gentlemen, look at the scores right now.
Oh, it's a tie.
It's a tie.
No, but guys, we still have one more round, man. We still have one more round.
One more round. Let's do it. Secondary school people, can you please come up on stage? So, do you want to use your trump card for your final round?
Wait. Yes. We have to choose...
Choose the category.
Yeah, choose what category?
Language.
Do you want to use your trump card?
Yes.
Oh!
All right.
Getting exciting, guys.
Getting exciting.
If you're ready, your time starts now.
Question 1. To carry the day. What does to carry the day...
Four. Yes.
Wow. To live in a fool's paradise.
Three. Yes.
To draw in one's horns.
One.
To lionize a person.
Three.
Wow. Out on a limb.
Three.
Three.
Yes.
Whoa. To whitewash.
Four.
Whoa. An axe to grind.
Three.
Three. Whoa! Coupe de grâce.
Four.
The finisher. Lily Livert.
Three.
Yes. And the last one, a pig in the poke.
Omega Fuma!
Turn, man. Wow.
Wow. We still got to play the last round, right?
Tertiary team, why don't you come to the center? We know you're not going to go down without a fight, man.
Yeah, man, you guys are not going to go down without a fight.
We'll try.
Which category would you like?
General knowledge.
General knowledge.
All right.
If you're ready, your time begins now.
Which of the following goals were not developed during the United Nations Conference on Sustainable Development in 2012?
Three.
In 2015, what was the agreed goal of limiting global temperature increase during the Conference of Parties in the Paris Agreement?
That's right.
All right. Question three. Under the Paris Agreement during the Conference of Parties, countries are required to report regularly on which of the following international review? Which of the following countries is not involved in the Syrian civil war crisis? According to the International Astronomical Union, a planet is defined to be in a celestial body that...
Wow.
According to NASA, Jet Propulsion Laboratory, the shift in Earth's poles are due to a magnetic field. Which of the following below does not fall under key pillars of sustainability?
Two.
In which water agreement was Singapore allowed to construct a dam across the Sungai Lingle? In 1927, water agreement... Which of the following systems is not considered to be a natural power source?
Three.
Let's give the Cheshire team a huge round of applause.
Woo!
Wow.
And the final score. The final score for the tertiary is at 1,900 points.
And for the secondary school is 3,200 points.
Woo!
So second place goes to the tertiary team, who walks away with $300 worth of CapitaLand vouchers and...
And the winning team is the secondary school team, who walks away with $450 worth of CapitaLand vouchers.
Let's give them a round of applause. Woo!
So church, let's give them a round of applause as they leave the stage. Thank you.
Wow, Ben.
Oh my goodness.
They are so smart.
So smart.
I'm so inspired.
The only Latin word I know is Soli Deo Gloria.
Pastor Bob,
Pastor Bob, I think you're here, Pastor Bob. Yes. Soli Deo, legit SOT student.
Well, guys, that's all we have from the both of us. We're going to turn over the time to
Pastor Tua. Big round of applause.
Wow, fantastic. Praise the Lord. How many of you are still enjoying yourself? So here in City Harvest Church, our young people are very brainy, very smart. Now, we often hear this saying, youth are the leaders of the future. Come. Yeah, let's give them a big hand. Praise the Lord. So what was I saying? You know, we always say youths are the leaders of the future. But here in City Harvest Church, we believe that youth are the leaders of the present. The leaders of today, the leaders of now. All right, so right now, we have three young people here in this place. They're all students. They're all cell group leaders in the church. So can we give them a big hand right now? So now I asked them to come to the stage because I want to interview them. So I want them to share with us some encouraging journey that they have gone through in City Harvest. So can you just introduce yourself quickly to us?
Hi everyone, I'm Jeanette and I'm from Laison. I'm now in SOT and I'm leading youth from W3A Civil.
Hi church, my name is Zen. Just like Jeanette, I'm in SOT this year and I'm leading a cell group of youth from F532.
Hi church, I'm Zen. I'm from Waizon and I lead S71, a youth group, and I'm currently studying in NUS Law.
Okay, praise the Lord. Now, Jeanette and Zen, so I understand that both of you became cell group leaders at a very young age. So can you share with us how that happened?
I received my calling after attending a youth camp when I was 17 years old, when my cell group leader randomly come up to me and say, "Hey, want to be cell group leader or not?" And then because of this statement, I became very convicted and I went back to pray about it. Then I received my calling. When I was 18 years old, I officially became a cell group leader during my second year of poly. But I was incredibly nervous because a large number of my members were much older than I am, and some of them were even a decade older.
A decade older? Wow.
Yeah.
I broke your flow.
And so in the beginning, it was really challenging because I have to lead a cell group of my peers, of people older than me, of people who were in church longer and more experienced than me. However, in the Bible it says, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. And because of that, I know that the Holy Spirit is here to guide me through. And so during my cell group meeting and during the times where I meet up with my members, I will always use the gift of prophecy to speak into their lives and to pray for them. And slowly but surely, they started to open up their lives to me. And because of this, I know that the Holy Spirit and the supernatural ministers beyond our experiences. And age is not a limitation.
Wow, let's give the Lord a big hand. Age is indeed not a limitation. Doesn't matter how young you are, God can use you. What about Zen?
I also became a cell group leader when I was 18 years old. I remember when our cell group first multiplied out, I struggled a lot with insecurities. During the first few months, I would always cry because I felt like I really didn't know what to do. Because, you know, I would think about things like, am I really called to be a cell group leader? Am I anointed enough? Or, you know, come on, I don't think I'm capable or qualified at all. You know, because I feel that leadership is just not my strength. It was always very uncomfortable for me to lead a group of people. And even thinking about where to eat for fellowship will give me a lot of stress. Yeah, so, you know, but one day, thank God, He spoke to me through John chapter 21, verse 15 to 17. You know, where Jesus asked Simon Peter, "Do you love me more than this?" for 3 times. And Peter said, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." And that's when Jesus told him, "Feed my lambs and tend my sheep." And it was through these verses that God reminded me why I wanted to serve as a cell group leader. It's because I love Him, I love Jesus, and the members who are entrusted to me, ultimately, they all belong to God. And from that day onwards, I decided to press through my struggles. And nowadays, when I lead and pray for my members, I just give my best and know that God will do the rest. I don't worry so much about what to do because I know that ultimately Jesus is the real cell group leader. Yeah, so all glory to God.
Amen. Praise God. So proud of you. When we do our best, God will do the rest. Now, what about you, Zhang? Share with us your leadership experience.
I think I can really identify with what Jeanette and what Zen shared, that when I first became a cell group leader, it was also incredibly challenging and stressful. I became a cell group leader last year when I multiplied with 23 members, but within 6 months, the number of members dropped to 11. And that wasn't the...
Wait, 23 members. 23 members when you multiplied, you dropped to 11.
11 members.
Wow.
And that wasn't the only issue, because out of the 11 members, there were only 3 boys who were regularly attending. So we used to have this joke that we were like a girls' school because there were so little boys in the cell group. But through it all, the Holy Spirit always reminded me to continue to pray, continue to be faithful in reading and sharing the Word of God. Because like what Pastor always shares with us, that really by prayer and by the Word of God that we become more aware of God's presence and God's power in our lives. And so I just continued to pray. And I think sometimes it sounds so simple to tell someone to pray, but I think as believers, it's actually the most powerful thing that we can do. And so through prayer, within 6 months, the number of boys in the cell group grew from 3 to 13 today. And I just...
Let's give God a big hand. 3 months from 3 to 13 boys.
And I just continued to be faithful in really reading and sharing the Word of God, no matter how small the cell group meeting may be or no matter how big it may be. And I think, Pastor, the real turning point came when I shared a word from Hosea, which Wayne, my zone supervisor, shared with us cell group leaders, to go and love again, even though it may have been difficult, to go and love your cell group again, go and love your church again. And I think the members really caught the word. For example, one of my members, Crystal Pong, through her, she indirectly brought close to 30 new friends who have been saved and integrated today. So by the grace of God, within 6 months, the cell group grew from 11 to 24 today.
Wow, let's give the Lord a big, big hand. We're so proud of you. Now, in City Harvest Church, we always encourage our young people to love the Lord, to serve Him, but we also emphasize a lot on academic excellence. So I understand that three of you, you are quite good at it. So share with us something to encourage all the students here.
Well, for me, I was concerned on whether I'm able to balance between my poly life and my new role as a cell group leader. However, I was reminded of what God spoke to me. And He told me that He wants me to be the salt and light in my campus and to do well for Him. And so I told myself that I need to work really hard to strike a balance. And sure enough, God is faithful and truly provides. In that very semester when I became a cell group leader, I got all A's for that semester.
Wow! I like what she said. I work very, very hard. All right, so nothing comes for free, right? You got to work hard.
And throughout the entire 3 years of my poly life, I got into the director's list for 5 out of 6 semesters. Wow. Graduated this April with a diploma with merit and securing a place in SMU.
Wow, praise the Lord. Director's list, then you're going to the university. What about Zen?
I really agree with what Janet said. Indeed, when we seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, all things shall be added to us. Even though leading a cell group can take up quite a lot of time, and sometimes it can be quite tiring, but God doesn't shortchange us. Yeah. When I first entered into polytechnic as a freshman, I decided that I want to do well in school so I could tell my new friends, my classmates, that it's all because I have Jesus. So by the grace of God, and because of really a lot of hard work, you know, I managed to get into the director's list in year one and year two. And just this year, I graduated with a diploma with merit in psychology. And right now, I'm waiting to enter into NTU with a scholarship offer.
A scholarship offer into NTU. And right now, you are in Bible school.
Yeah, as
Bible school.
Two of us.
And going to university and scholarship, etc. Wow, what about Zeng?
I believe, Pastor, that if we water others, we ourselves will also be watered. So I became a cell group leader last year when I was entering my 3rd year of law school. So generally the 3rd and 4th year of law school is slightly more challenging because it is a time that we've got to decide what area of law we want to specialize in. And I think it's the same for other faculties as well. We've got to decide what you want to major in. And it isn't as simple as just deciding what subjects or what modules to choose, but because you've got to ask yourself, like, will I do well for it? I mean, you can't possibly want to specialize or major in something and do badly for it. And so I can really understand what Jeanette and what Zen shared, that it was incredibly stressful and challenging because on the one hand, we have to balance our heavy workload, tight deadlines, late nights, balance all of that together with cell group ministry where there's so much more responsibility as a cell group leader. But really, if you water others, you yourself will also be watered. By the grace of God, my results on my 3rd year were the best results I've received in law school so far. I took 8 modules across the year and got 6 A's and 2 B's. And really, I really agree with what Jeanette and what Zen shared, that first and foremost, it's really about discipline, that you got to be willing to work hard, put in the time and effort, and emerge as students, we got to realize that we are called to do well in our studies. But at the same time, as believers, let us never forget to really pray and to really trust God that if He placed you in it, He will bring you through it.
Wow, let's give the Lord a big hand. Praise God. Now, you guys mentioned about working hard. Tell us exactly how do you focus and work hard? Zen, you shared with me a tip.
When you study, right, on the airplane mode on your phone.
Yeah. Airplane mode on a phone. No distraction. Put aside your phone. Just focus. Very good. Okay, our time is up. Just tell us one statement you want to tell all the youth. Just share with us one statement.
When you are called by God, follow your calling and He will guide you.
Amen.
Everything you do, do your best for God and do it unto the Lord.
Yes.
Pray and always seek the kingdom of God first in everything you do.
Brilliant. Let's give our young people a big hand. Jeanette, Zan, and Zhang. Let's give them a big hand. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen.